Hey folks, my name is Johan and I'm a senior cloud developer advocate working at Microsoft. In this video, we'll discover all the new features of the Static Web Apps CLI. For this demo, we'll start from this shopping app example that we've built in the previous videos. As you can see, this project is a monorepo containing four different versions of the front-end app built using different frameworks. We also have an API built with Node.js and Azure Functions. So, how can I get started with the Static Web Apps CLI and what can it do for me? First, make sure that you have the CLI installed by tapping swa-v in your terminal. You should see the version you have installed. If you need to install it, you'll find the link in the video description. Now to have a look at what commands I can use, I can tap swa-help. You'll get the list of all the commands and options, and you can see we have new interesting commands like deploy, init, or build. It also tells me that I can get started by typing just swa. So I'll do that. The first thing it will do is create a configuration for my project. So let's choose React for the name of this configuration. And as I have multiple apps here, I need to choose which one I want to configure. So I'll pick React app for this one. Now, as you can see, the CLI has detected which framework I'm using and set the configuration for me. It also detected that I have an API and where it's located. If needed, I could change some of the settings, but here it just looks good to me. Now, it's installing all the dependencies if needed, and it builds my application using the command set previously. And then it asked me the final question, do I want to deploy my app? Yes, definitely. So first I need to log in. So I was already logged in my browser, so that should be fine. Now I need to choose on which subscription I want to deploy my app. And if I want to deploy over an existing application or create a new one. So in my case, I want to create a new one. Let's pick a name, SWA API React, sounds fine. Now it's creating all the stuff for me and it's deploying. Should take a few seconds. What you can see is that I didn't have to create a GitHub repo, set up a CI/CD workflow, but if you plan to build a serious app, you'll probably want to do that at some point. Here, I can have my app just deployed like that. So now I can get this URL and have a look at my deployed app. Yep, it's there. Now, if we go back to our project, we can see that there's a new file here called swa-cli.config.json. In this file, we can find all the configuration settings we set earlier for our project. This file can be committed to your repo and shared with your teammates so they don't have to go through the whole setup again. The more sensible information are stored in this .env file, which should not be committed this time. You can also see that your .gettingNow file was updated just to avoid that. Now, my app is deployed, but if I want to change something, I would like to test it locally before deploying it. I can do that using the swa start command. Using the configuration I set earlier, it will start everything I need to test my app locally. It will start the React Dev Server, it will start the API, and now I can get this URL. Okay, it's working. If I go back to my code and make some changes, I can see them directly. And now when I'm ready to redeploy my app with these new changes, I can use the swa command again to build and redeploy my app. That's it for this video. In the next one, we'll see how we can fully debug our app without ever leaving Visual Studio Code.